What is up, everyone? Jeff here, no cutscenes, back with part three of my Toy Factory Let's Build. Finally, yeah, sorry it's been a couple days, but I just wanted to actually kind of run through a few things again, just make sure it's perfect. But yeah, now it's pretty much set to go. As far as the actual builder system, where everything is constructed, dropped on conveyors, transported to where we're going to have like a little, you know, toy shop, warehouse, factory, whatever you want to call it. That's pretty much all done. I've done a little bit with the lighting, of course, just to make it so it's, you know, somewhat actually okay. And it's not just, you know, dark and creepy and dank and shit. But let me show you a little change I made here. If y'all remember from the last one, I just initially had this lift drop right onto that conduit. I've actually taken it up another floor and have it drop through like a, almost like a chute. So I really like how this came out. Basically just drops like that rocket ship straight down. And because of that little chute that I made with the lockers for the alien or teddy bear, or I can't even remember what fucking one it was, it's gonna go perfectly. Yeah, so as you can see, drops in. That was the only change I think I've made to the lifts, but yeah, let's go ahead and let's get building. So first of all, gotta figure out where we wanted it exactly placed, but we're gonna have to kind of work with the actual conveyor belts because they're gonna kind of dictate. I actually lucked out here and it ended up using one of the turn pieces, right turn, there you go, and it went down straight underneath those supports perfectly. And I'm just really happy with that. If it didn't, I mean, of course we would have always been able to find something, maybe work around like a drop down, but yeah, kind of lucked out there. I hope if y'all are building something similar that y'all just get lucky. No, fuck it, it's skill. Yeah, we're all skillful out here. So yeah, basically I just wanted to make like kind of something underneath Red Rocket, and I thought it was pretty cool with all like the gas shit and everything, and just the way that it looked, like it looks like, you know, a toy shop. I don't know, I like it. And we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna use it like the sorters a few times. I'll go over kind of in detail what they do in a minute, but for right now, we're just getting everything set up. They need kind of a lot of clearance. So all I had to do here was just place one of the other conveyor belts, one of the smaller ones, and enable me to do that. So yeah, there we have the component sorter. That is the more complex of it, but I think it's the more versatile one because you can basically, what it does is whatever component you have in there, that's what's going to be sorted out. So if you have steel, steel will be sorted out, and whatever is not steel will continue on straight. Just the regular sorter, whatever item you have in there, that's what will be sorted. So if say you have steel wanting to be sorted out, but you also have like a bunch more of those builders that require steel, you can have it sorted out, but then you can actually have things sorted out even further and further. Like, you'll see in a second what I mean by that. I know it's kind of hard to explain, but yeah, there we go. We have base of our sorter. Cool. All right. So now let's go ahead. We'll build around it, starting over here. And I wanted to use the same color scheme. And I like these barns from, I forget the mod, but they're really good. Port Royal. There we go. Yeah. And even though they're under the barn category, they're not as like tall as the normal barn wall pieces, but that's okay because they do come with their own set of like roof, other sets of walls and stuff like that, so it's fine. But if you want, definitely go check it out. It's one of like the highest rated on the store or whatever the mod marketplace is, I don't know. But yeah, Port Royal, it's really good. And so yeah, let's just go ahead and finish this up because it's a toy store. Like, even though it's, you know, post-nuclear fallout and shit, you still gotta bring some cheer to some kids, I guess. Yeah, maybe. Or, you know what? Let's just sell it and make a shit ton of money. How about that? Yeah. No, I like that. Okay. So, gonna have to replace some stuff here, but not a big deal. Again, lucked out really, really well because just the place that I was able to put this, it kind of just ignored a lot of collision, which I was really, really happy about. Yeah, and you'll see here in a second that we're actually gonna use the floor pieces for some of the roof. Now, I use that just because I like to be able to kind of see down into it if I'm standing up top, but also because it just snaps right to one of the existing Port Royal barn pieces. It's not like the wood where you have to do the upper shack floor piece and whatnot. It just snaps on real easy, and it lets us know if there's going to be gaps, especially with the support. And I kind of knew that was coming, but that's okay. We don't need it to be completely closed in. We just need it to be closed in enough. So we had that little viewing window there for the drop down. I kind of wanted to do the same thing here, so you can kind of check, see if anything's happening. Just keep an eye on things. Now, if you saw there for a second, like, it does snap. I could have done that, but I actually did, and I recorded it and everything, but it actually ended up not working out. Just the way that the roof worked, it only ended up covering like a part of it, so it wasn't worth it. Like, if you were going for something that didn't have a roof, I would have probably done it, but yeah, no. Need to have a roof on this thing. Need to protect our toys. It's our investment. So basically, easiest way to kind of do something here is going to be using like the shack upper floor, finding out whatever other wall piece. Again, it's okay if we use one different wall piece. Mostly we want it to be that Port Royal barn, the multicolor shit, but it's just, it won't let us put one underneath here. So we're going to have to use just, you know, something in the meantime. And I love these metal windows. Like, they're wall pieces. I think they're... Are they from the actual expansion? I don't know, because it doesn't say, like... Maybe I just can't read it because my preview quality is so shit, but it might be the SSEX, the Settlement Supplies Expanded. If not, I will definitely figure that out in a second. I just am too lazy to adjust my preview quality. But yeah, so, and then that's good because it enables us to actually like put a roof up there and everything. So yeah, pretty happy with that. And if we want, we can even use, you know, one of the floors from the barns. But what you're gonna see here is something that's really weird with the roof if you actually like connect it to the barn pieces. Now, what I was saying was it's really good. It is. If you have it as like kind of a standalone thing. Now, what I mean by that is, like, you just have it as, say, like a cabin or a bar or something out, you know, on your property, on one of your settlements. But for some reason, whenever there's something above it, even if it's just like, say, like scaffolding or, just a second level, it does this weird drop down, and I don't know why. So, yeah, you see here, like, it doesn't actually go up onto the side where that little, angled piece for the roof should be. It's really weird, and yeah, so I'm not going to use that here, and that's why, again, I was saying earlier, we actually went ahead and used the floor pieces because they enabled us to see through it because it has that mesh or screen or whatever you want to call it, and it just looks good. But for some reason, these work perfectly fine. I don't know why. It's still the Port Royal. It's still that colored one, but the ones that are actually just like, you know, nothing else, nothing too fancy, they were completely fine. I don't know what it is. They'll even clip through this shit here, which is fucking fantastic. I mean, I'm definitely not complaining about that. I'm just complaining about we can't have the entire roof with this colored Port Royal shit, even though it looks really good. So, but, you know, again, this is a very lucky build. We were able to luck out, able to put the taller wall, the one with the point there, so it actually looks flush. And this is nice too, because these actually will come up and you can, if you want, put floor down underneath. I ended up not doing that just because I wanted to kind of go with, hey, we came to Red Rocket, we took it over, we built a toy factory, it's a fucking empire, and you're going to buy our shit. So I don't really care if there's a floor on the ground. If it doesn't save us money, why would we use it, you know? So, no. I know it's just like a really stupid thing to think of, but still, it's, you know, it's fun. I've been playing this game for so long, you gotta change it up, you know. So now, I actually fucked up here a little bit. I didn't realize that I would actually need a place to walk around the storage and sorter system. But I fixed that really quickly in just a couple minutes. But yeah, this is just a good showcase of these windows. Now, I mean, they're just good. Like, they look good. They have different textures for each one of them. It's not just the same brown shit repeating over. I mean, it's still a lot of brown shit, but you know, you kind of can't get away from that in this Fallout. But yeah, I mean, they give you windows, like actual windows, and they snap into each other, so you can do some kind of crazy things. Now, you don't have to use one of like the doorway pieces with the railing to make some makeshift window. I mean, that's why I love mods. I don't like mods that enable you to do things that anybody else can't do. If everybody else can do it, like, I think it's fine. It only adds to the game. It doesn't take anything away from it or just make it any easier. It just gives you more shit, which is awesome. Because, honestly, my favorite part of this game is building. And that's what I want to do. I love, of course, exploring and the RPG aspect of it, but I like the building. I don't know why. I like creating things. And this is amazing. So, yeah. Alright, but enough of me rambling, as I always do. Let's finish up our... You know what? No. It's gonna be a storefront. Yeah. Little bit. Like, you know, like one of those gas station Hess storefront things. We can buy, like, weird, crappy, random, shitty toys at the side of a gas station or a truck stop. Yeah. Pennsylvania. Okay. But now, let's go ahead, finish up the actual entrance here. Again, we are just lucking out. See, this shit, like, I don't know what it is, if it's just the ability for this shit to clip through everything, or I really don't know. I'm just really happy with how it came out, because I mean, even here, like, you can see, like, it doesn't want to. You kind of have just, of course, have to find the right angle, but it will, which is really nice. Like, it's even clipping through all that, like, junk and debris. I mean, eventually, of course, you know, it's gonna take a second, because yeah, there you go. See, bam. Now,
what the hell is happening there? Oh, I still have that up.
Sorry, I had something else up. And here, I ended up changing it a little bit, just because I want to be actually able to, you know, get in to where the storage is, as opposed to just walling it off and calling it a day. I kind of used the concrete here just to make a penis, just to warn y'all, because I was kind of getting, I don't know, a little drunk maybe at this point making it. And I thought, yeah, let's make a concrete dick. So, you're gonna see that in a second. But first, I try a few different things just to see, like, you know, what the levels are gonna be like. But here's a really good tip for, like, concrete that you're gonna see in a second. And what I was trying to do here with the upper floor was that I didn't want to have an entire wall. I just wanted to have this half wall, kind of like coming out from the side there and then making a dick. But I basically did that little technique where you put up the floor, put the shack upper floor, move it back, and then you essentially have a new spot to place a wall underneath, especially with these half walls. Now, the half walls are only from a mod, but I highly recommend getting them. I think, again, it's Settlement Supplies Expanded, if I'm not mistaken. Now, what I wanted to do here was make the tip, yep, and then have it so that the actual level that the floor is, or the level of the floor, is one lower than the one that I already made. Now, I just wanted to do this just, I don't know, I think I wanted to make it like a little watchtower that I ended up not using because, you know, you don't really need it. Like, I have a, what is it, a few turrets that I've actually put up since. So yeah, I don't even need a watchtower, but I just wanted to make a dick. I don't know why. But yeah, it's really easy to do, especially with concrete. Like, if you want to learn how to just push, say, the floor down one level without having to do anything too complicated, you basically just take one of the curved concrete pieces, as I was doing. Take one of the curved floor pieces once you place the concrete piece at the height you want it, and bam, there you go. If you place, say, one of the normal walls next to the curved piece, and then a floor piece off it, it'll be one higher than that. So you can actually have, like, little, you know, drop down, do dens really easy. And I know I did, like, a full explanation of how to do, you know, multi-level houses, where it's not just, like, a full floor, it's one of those small wooden stairs, or just, like, you know, two or three of the shack floors stacked on top of each other. So definitely check that out if you want to learn how to do it, crazy amount. But just for one, it's a really easy technique. So we're gonna have to compromise here, because we're not gonna be able to put one of those floor pieces where that support is. Bummer. But what can you fucking do? It's not the end of the world. As long as we can close up a good majority, or even, you know, I would go more than that, like 75% of this building, I'm gonna be fine. That's just me. If y'all need to make it perfect, if y'all are even, you know, doing this, whatever, go for it. Please do. And I really actually want to see, like, some of the things y'all have been building, because I've been checking out a few, but I just haven't seen a lot of new things lately. So yeah, send me, please, like, links if you have, like, Imager albums, or if you have, like, YouTube tours of it and shit. I'd love to check it out. So yeah, just throwing that in there. All right, but let's get back to building. Now, I know this is a little bit boring, just basically watching me finish out my penis here, but don't worry, it'll get better in a second. Now, I wanted to take this away just because you don't really need that, like, one random-ass fucking wooden wall, like, right there, when you have these concrete ones surrounding it. So, real easy, take it away, take these away, take that away, attach it to the curved wall. It is the length of the full one, so it's 8 of those columns, or posts, or whatever the fuck you want to call them. Bam, good to go. Now, this is what I actually ended up changing. I changed this because, as you can see, you can't actually get in there unless you take away the wall itself. And that just kind of gets a little annoying after, you know, doing it for 20 minutes. Going in and out of the workshop menu, it's just a fucking headache. So I eventually ended up just using one of the, what was it, the wood, I think they're shack and roof piece. I don't even know what they're called, but they're those, like, half pieces and shit. You'll see it in a second. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And then this here is a pain too, because why can't we just do a corner? It would be so nice if the corner just worked really well. But hey, what can you do? And I was thinking, you know, since we had the one with the point, the roof kind of slope on the other side, we should do it on this side. Now, what I did here for this wall was actually use the multi-select, and it was much easier than actually trying to snap it. So if y'all don't know what the multi-select is by now, I know I have a video of it. There's, I'm sure, hundreds if not thousands of small tutorials on it. Go check it out. It's really easy and you can do it a lot with it. So this is where I said I fucked up. I needed to make a little walkway that just so I could get around. Nothing too fancy, you know, it didn't have to be too big. It didn't have to take up the rest of the entire space of Red Rocket down underneath in the gas station, but just something to the point where I could actually walk around. And basically I saw that because I know that I'm able to snap these floor pieces to that Port Royal barn multicolor shit. So, and I know that with the shack upper floor, I'm able to use those half wall pieces to essentially just place underneath the shack upper floor pretty much where I want. And yeah, I just had to extend it by one, forgot that it clips through that support there and won't let us do it. But essentially, that's all you have to do. And if you just want to get, like, a half wall lined up like I did, you can do that. You can even use the bureau, which I ended up using as, like, a half wall. You can use one of the concrete ones. It's up to you, depending on how you want your actual, you know, toy factory or death barn or whatever the fuck you're building to look. So yeah, I was kind of deciding on whether or not I wanted to do one of these, but it would ended up, yeah, I'm glad I didn't, because if I did, there would have been no room for that conveyor store. Yeah. Oh, and just quick heads up for all the people who want Amazing Contraptions DLC mods, get Manufacturing Extended. I think it's by Kennington or Kensington or something. It's on the Xbox store, I know. It's the best thing out there for the mods. As far as, like, manufacturing, it just gives you what you actually fucking need to be able to make, like, infinite loops. I'll have a video coming out today showcasing everything in it. It should be, like, maybe, like, 6, 7, maybe 8 minutes long, but it's fucking amazing. So yeah, okay, no more tangents, let's finish up the building. Now, since we know, again, with this Port Royal barn pieces, we can snap floors to them, basically using these as roofs if we're in, like, a tight spot or we just don't have enough room. I probably should have kept that upper piece, but I actually did test to see if I could walk underneath it, and for some reason there was, like, an area where I actually couldn't even walk underneath. So maybe I'll figure out how I can bump it up one or something like that, but as of now, it's fine with just using those shack floor pieces. So again, like I was saying, you can use either, of course, like, those half wall pieces, you can use the concrete. I went with the concrete here because I wanted to have like a little sign, and it would just look better on the concrete, and the concrete is a little bit taller. There's not as much of a gap. I think it just looks like a little bit junkier too, which I love. Like, I love that fucking junk style. And even though there's a gap in between the actual wall and the concrete wall, I'm okay with that. No one's gonna get in there. Like, the smallest creature in the game couldn't even get in there. Like, a rad chicken couldn't even get in there. So we'll be fine. Alright, now let's go ahead. We, gonna go and reattach our storage conveyor here. Just putting on the finishing touches. Okay, so then after this, we're actually gonna go ahead and test everything. So, yes. I am so excited for this. I actually haven't even tested everything yet. I've literally just been building and, like, I'm saying kind of, fuck it, hopefully it goes well. I don't know if that's the best strategy. It is, well, no, I know that is not the best strategy, but we're just gonna hope, okay? We've been lucky in all this shit so far, so we're just gonna hope. Now, here's what I was saying, where, like, you can have it down one, as far as, like, you know, your floor pieces or your den or whatever you want to call it. But this is actually an example where it doesn't work out. But it's really easy to fix because you always have that snap point. So yeah, but again, it's just good to know that you can do something like this. So you can see, like, there's just a weird little gap between the roof and the actual floor piece. And if I would have used a roof, I'm sure it would have covered it, but just the way that the supports are from the Red Rocket gas station, couldn't even use roofs. Yeah, it was a real bummer. Pretty much every place I tried to put one, just wouldn't let it. Yeah. Suck. Dick. Okay, but now I am just fixing it. Putting on, you know, one of these longer floors just so it looks like it's actually supported. Moving all the rest of them back up. Placing the, I think, last piece, actually. Yeah, this little mesh floor. So that if I wanted to, I could stand up top and watch all the toys coming in. Gives it a little bit more junky feel. I don't know, I like it. And last but not least, we gotta close this one. Let's go ahead, we'll put bureau. It's just the easiest thing to do. Could have put one of the, I guess, one of those half walls, but there's just so much, like, room left at the top. It just looks really funny. All right, but let's go ahead. Let's test this shit out. So here we have Red Rocket Toy Company. I'm pretty proud of it, you know? I think it looks good. It looks pretty solid for a build that took maybe, I don't know, 4 hours total? Yeah, and I mean, like, I really didn't decorate it or anything that much as far as, like, making it homey, but I made some changes here. We got, you know, room for the employees and stuff. We got a little check-in. Some more area just, you know, to live, food, and then we have this from the outside, and this was the change that I was talking about. I just made a little entrance so I could actually get in and grab this shit. Now, as you can actually see, there's already some stuff in there, but that was just me testing the hopper system and making sure that everything went in there. So, but let's go over the sorter. So, the way that sorters work, just the sorter, whatever you put in there is going to be sorted out. So if you put a toy alien, the toy alien is going to be sorted out. Now, the component sorter is a little different. It follows the same principle, but it's just with components. So say if you know something has plastic in it and you want that object to be sorted out, you put plastic in there. And I know that Jangles has plastic. So Jangles has plastic, so he will be sorted out, and whatever else has plastic will also be sorted out. But say whatever doesn't contain plastic will not be sorted out. Or if you want to use like a component sorter to, say, build something, you can do it that way too, which we'll go into in the next actual manufacturing extend video. But let's do this shit, y'all. We gotta turn all these on. And next one, I'm definitely doing a central power source. I think this one, it was just because I knew I was gonna be doing it very vertical, and with the scaffolding, it was just gonna be a pain. But again, for like the next thing I'm going to be doing, it's going to be like the ball tracks and shit. So that's going to be off a central source. But all right, let's get watching. Cool. We got Vault Tech launch boxes. I don't think we did the teddy bear because for some reason they always get fucking jammed. But yeah, let's see. We got Jangles being made. Yeah. We got some Jangleses. And the reason I have them just continually diverted is because that's just where the hopper was, the best place for it. Got the rocket ship, should drop down in there. Okay, cool. Jangle's dropping. And yeah, this thing is really fucking cluttered, and I love it. I'm really happy with the way it came out. I'm just glad that everything is so square. Yeah. Cool. We got everything dropping in. There's a bunch of stuff going. You know, we're probably going to have some casualties. Maybe a few things that'll just fall off. Like, the Jangles is pretty big, so sometimes he'll just fall off. Yeah, it's unfortunate. But, hey, at least that stuff's going in. You know, there's our first casualty. But the rocket ship was the one I was most worried about because it just dropped, like, you know, from 40 feet. But that one's fine, too. So now we got this shit in the hopper. Cool, cool, cool. All right. Let's go check out down below the conveyor belt. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I forgot to wire the damn second hopper. Thing's not open yet. All right, let me go wire that really quick. That is my bad. Sorry to ruin the experience, y'all. All right, now let's go check out our building. So there we go. We got the hopper drop in. Should be a lot more because that one had the majority. I think it probably had close to like 3/4 of all the shit going through that one. Yeah. All right, now that's good. Okay, cool. So now we have our little assembly line and just a sorting line. So let's go check it out actually inside. And of course, I just decorated a little bit. It has to be, you know, like a little factory, a little toy shop. Just a little place to check, make sure everything's doing well. So now as you can see, because I put the toy alien in the sorter, the toy alien itself is being sorted out. Now, like I was saying with the component sorter, whatever component you put in there, that item will be sorted out. And like I was saying, the Jangles has plastic. So I know that that is going to be sorted out, but it is not the toy alien. So on the second sorter, it will not be sorted out. It will just continue on straight. So yeah, we're having Jangles explosion shit. But yeah, that's pretty much it, you know, guys. Like, there's going to be a lot of practical uses, I'm sure, especially for, like, survival mode. But I'm just having a lot of fun with this shit. Just figuring out, like, different systems. I'm going to be playing a lot more with, like, the logic gates and the component sorters in the future. Definitely going to be doing some guides on that for y'all. If y'all can think of anything that you want to know or just maybe, you know, confused on or just want to see more of, please tell me. I will be glad to do some videos. I'm going to be putting out that ball track Let's Build soon. I've already finished about 2/3 of it. So yeah, I just got to do the commentary for it. And again, I apologize for this one being late. I wanted to get out the conveyor belt system because I knew that I was going to be doing a manufacturing mods extended system like video anyway. So yeah, I wanted to get that out, but yeah, we got our little toy factory. I think Jangles will be proud. I'm really glad with the way this came out. But yes, as I keep saying, download manufacturing extended. It's not even an option, really. If you want to have functionality out of these contraptions, you really need it. Now, like I was saying, I really enjoyed it, like the contraptions mod, but this DLC, or this mod, or I really enjoyed the contraptions DLC. This mod makes it amazing. Just trust me. Go get it right now. It's super small. It's only like maybe a couple hundred kilobytes. Like, it's fucking amazing. And it works. That's the best part. I haven't run into any problems. It's really good. But thank you. Thank you all so much for watching. It was a long journey. It's like an hour and a half. Like, it was watching a movie. But I'm glad we got to do it. I'm glad we got to build this. Stay tuned. I'm going to have that manufacturing extended video out today. And the ball track, mouse trap, whatever, out tomorrow. See you guys. Thanks for watching.